Welcome to More Creepy Videos, and let's dive in.
I'm gonna show you guys something crazy. Have you ever seen something so crazy?
With the way things are going and how fast this world is moving, it'll only be a matter of time before we have to use digital IDs to actually buy fast food, or even groceries for that matter.
People who have married objects. Erica Labrie married the Eiffel Tower. Aaron Chervenak married his smartphone. Pascal Selig married her own duvet. Amy Wolf married a roller coaster. Myra Voni Rachamarays married a doll. Richard Torres married a tree. Carol Santa married a train station.
How do you even marry a roller coaster? I mean, look, listen, I get it, you might get super excited, you might even have the ride of your life, but at the same time, there's no valid reason to actually marry the flipping thing.
This is how easy it is for a hacker to hack you off the things you post on social media.
Hey, Serena.
Pay attention, yeah. Because this can
what
be you.
Got in your bag? It's my new heels for graduation.
Name. They already got your name. Right there.
Good
this
morning,
is y'all
guys.
Right now.
It's what it is. It's my birthday.
Now they got your birthday. In the day. In the address, because you posted it. And they got your banking card because you posted it. Oh, you already got. You done got. Purchase confirmed. If y'all don't want to end up like Sabrina did, I advise y'all to be aware of what y'all post. Posting all your information online, you're making a hacker's job easy. Yeah, let me know your thoughts on this video in the comments.
This clip unlocked a new fear and spiked anxiety levels.
The average Englishman. He wakes up and he turns on his taxed telly. He leaves his heavily taxed house.
After putting on his heavily taxed clothes and heavily taxed shoes.
Gets in his heavily taxed car. He fills it with heavily taxed diesel.
After paying heavily taxed insurance and road tax and tax on MOT.
He gets to work to earn an income, which after employee national insurance, a third of his income has disappeared.
On income tax. After feeling taxed from work, he returns back to his neighborhood, where he's reminded of council tax. He parks the car to go to the shop and...
His purchases are taxed at 20%. He calls in for a pint, over two-thirds of the cost of which goes in tax.
After making peanuts, he spends peanuts on peanuts and peanut tax.
He dreams of a family holiday abroad, but he can't afford the airport tax.
Then there's inheritance tax, gift tax, stamp duty tax, reserve tax, corporation tax.
He longs for the day that he can retire, the financial transaction tax. The poor sap doesn't even know we've nicked it. It's difficult for you, isn't it, to imagine his distress? Because you're not in this game, are you? You don't pay any of this.
And pretty soon we're going to have to pay tax for breathing in air, but we all know that the system has been rigged for those in power.
All these creators got banned on the same day. Something's about to happen, and they don't want people with big followings spreading the news or misinformation. It's not a coincidence all these truthers over 100,000 followers got banned on the same day.
Yeah, I'm one of those creators that lost his account yesterday. And I guess it's just a coincidence that yesterday, the Supreme Court allows White House to press social media companies to remove disinformation. At the same time, this is happening. The Federal Reserve was hacked, apparently, and 33 terabytes of data was breached. Again, 33, that is the signal. And by the way, the last video I made on my main account that got hit for community guideline violations was talking about this news article. And something else I find extremely odd, I made a video today with a hashtag, this right here, I don't want to say it, so this video doesn't get taken down, and the hashtag was removed. And if you type that word into the search bar on TikTok, you will have this come up. So it's almost like TikTok is trying to suppress this. So are they trying to prepare for something coming? We have a lot of distractions, the debate tonight. We have 4th of July next week. Yeah, I don't know. But hey, I'm just some crazy conspiracy theorist pushing misinformation, whatever. It is what it is, guys. But we keep our eyes focused upon Jesus. He's the author and the perfecter of our faith. He will discern everything going on right now. Just focus upon him. Allow him to guide you and rest in him, because the enemy is trying to cause division, trying to cause anger and frustration. Do not allow it. Love you all so much. God bless. And remember, the just shall live by faith.
We know something big is coming. We just don't know what it is yet, but we do all have our own ideas on what that may be. And as for the last video, I apologize for those comments being turned off. I didn't turn those comments off. I've been having a battle with YouTube for the past 6 weeks or more, because every time I change my settings to comments on, I check it an hour later or 2 hours later and it's automatically getting turned off, and they're doing that multiple times per video. And also a lot of members from the community are having to resubscribe again and let me know in the comments that they've had to resubscribe because YouTube keep on subscribing them. So if you can, guys, go ahead and smash that like button and subscribe button, because it will definitely help me out and help the channel out, and I really would appreciate it. Thanks, guys.
An insidious human trafficking operation at Comic-Con has been busted, saving the lives of 10 victims. The 3-day sting operation was conducted by the San Diego Human Trafficking Task Force, which made 14 arrests, with multiple victims being saved, one of which was a 16-year-old girl. Attorney General Rob Bonta later said that traffickers capitalize on large-scale events such as Comic-Con, and that these arrests send a clear message to potential offenders.
It's great to hear that these young ones got saved, and it's also great to see that these traffickers are getting caught, but it's kind of scary in its own sense, because it seems like trafficking is becoming more and more frequent and more common these days. I'm sorry, but all I could think about was this.
How many humans does it take to make 17,000 human flesh capsules? A few years ago at Incheon International Airport in South Korea, customs officers are doing routine checks in the incoming luggage. They're like, wait, don't let that one through. The scans are all ringing off on that one. The customs officers, they pull a few suitcases off to the side, they open them up, and they're just staring at each other. They're staring at thousands, almost 20,000. So not even just thousands, like think about 20,000 pills stuffed into clear Ziploc plastic bags. Clear capsules that have this weird dark orange, almost brownish powder inside. No label, no identifying markers, no bottle, just pills inside plastic bags. I mean, they do kind of look like supplements, but I mean, do you really need 17,000 pills in a plastic bag for a light vacation? And so South Korea being South Korea, the first thought they have is drugs. We have just stumbled upon a massive narcotic smuggling operation. To them, this is El Chapo level activity. They confiscate all the pills. They start testing every single one of them. What the hell is in this? Some of the pills were tested and they showed high levels of superbacteria. Superbacteria is typically a bacteria that cannot be killed with antibiotics. So if it's ingested by a human, it's very hard to kill it once it's inside your system.
It's like a virus.
Yeah, they're like antibiotic resistant. So is this some sort of bioterrorism attack? Yeah, I mean, they're gonna pass these out to civilians and get them sick on bacteria that are hard to treat. It's gonna cause an outbreak. I mean, it's not gonna kill the country, but it is gonna cause problems. It would have been a very strange plan, though, which gave someone an idea. They test the pills for something else, and they finally come back positive. The pills were a match for humans. Human flesh. Powdered, concentrated, packed into neat little doses, the pills were made from powdered humans. There were even little hairs found inside the capsules. But where would you even get the raw material for the human flesh capsules?
That's just a really strange case, and he sounds to me like he would have been a very busy man. But my question here is, where the hell did he get the flesh for the pills? And if the pills weren't used for human consumption, then what the hell were they used for?
Let's play a game. I'm about to give you a bunch of random situations, and you can tell me how many random coincidences the world is full of. So this is Ari DeGoe. He patented technology on free energy. He was headed to the airport to go meet some investors, but he never made it to his flight because he was found dead in his car. That's random. This is Stefan Marinov. He is the leader of the European Free Energy Movement. In 1997, he had a major breakthrough, and as they were working on their prototype, he was found dead. What? Yeah, apparently he fell out of a window. This is Dr. John Mullen. He is a nuclear physicist that worked for one of the largest military contractors in the world. Apparently, he discovered something really big in the realm of energy, but unfortunately, before he could come out with this information, he died from arsenic poisoning. But don't worry, his girlfriend was the primary suspect. She was actually found dead in her apartment as well. They didn't go after any other suspects. Case closed. This right here is Dmitry Petrinov. He invented a plasma battery that powered his two-story house for 14 months. One day he went to go get bread from a bakery and was never seen again. Zachary Warfield was also working on a plasma battery. He actually met with Dmitry a couple of times where they would exchange notes. He mysteriously died in a boating accident in Washington, D.C. Eugene Malov was an expert physicist in cold fusion. He claimed to have a working prototype of a free energy device, but the day before he was going to go public, he was beaten to death. That's so random. Rory Johnson invented a cold fusion motor that generated over 500 horsepower. The Department of Energy took a restraining order against the technology so he could never publicize it, and you're never going to guess what happened to him. Everyone who knew him said he was super healthy, had no health issues, but he died mysteriously. Mark Tomian was awarded a patent for a zero-point energy system. After he developed his working prototype, he was found mysteriously dead, and the crazy thing is his research is missing. What? Or you might recognize this one. This is Stan Thompson. He developed a car that ran off of water. After developing his working prototype, he went to go to lunch with two investors so that he could gain money to push this technology out there. He died during lunch. His last words were, "I've been poisoned." Nikola Tesla believed he could make free energy. And all of his research was funded by, guess who? J.P. Morgan. When he claimed to have figured it out and he wanted additional capital so that he could expand his inventions, J.P. Morgan shut him down. I'm sure it has nothing to do with the fact that J.P. Morgan owned General Electric, he owned copper mines, he owned rubber mills. Anyways, the reason why the world has so much inequality, the reason why things are so expensive, it has nothing to do with the fact that we keep inventing technology that can help people, but we suppress it. Anyways, I don't know. What do you guys think? Isn't that crazy? What coincidences? The world is a weird place.
It sounds to me like if you're looking for certain death, then developing your own free energy is definitely the way to go.
Is this how they get away with saying the earth is round? The earth is round. The earth is an oblate spheroid. The earth is an oblate spheroid. I've been looking at oblate spheroids, and look how they have this flat plane in the center. Flat plane in the center. Here's a definition of an oblate spheroid. Dimensional collection of points, flat surface, a three-dimensional collection of points whose cross-sections is a curve, curved surface of the boundary of any three-dimensional solid. In general, a surface is a continuous boundary dividing three-dimensional space into two regions. For example, the surface of a sphere separates the interior from the exterior. A horizontal plane separates the half plane above from the half plane below. Horizontal plane, half plane above, half plane below. Oblate spheroid, plane in the center. Oblate spheroid, plane in the center. Oblate spheroid, plane in the center. Round, round, sphere. So all these scientists, when they say Earth is round or an oblate spheroid, you've got this in your mind. When really, they're not even lying to you. It's round and it's an oblate spheroid.
What I don't understand is, and this might be a silly question, but why do they feel the need to lie that the Earth is a globe?
Imagine being a plumber and getting called out to unclog a drain seemed routine enough, right? Until you realize, I have to call the police because I'm pretty sure I just stumbled upon a crime. Let me show you.
Communications.
I'm a plumber and I'm on site for a job, and we're snaking a drain, and we've been pulling back. We probably pulled back about 10 pounds, 15 pounds of, like, it looks like flesh type of stuff, meat, and we don't know what it is.
The issue started several days before. He didn't want any plumbers called. He tried snaking the drain himself. He was taking efforts to fix it. By the 29th, it was getting so bad. The smell, the pipes were backing up into the people's bathtubs. people upstairs just took it upon themselves to call a plumber. The officers on the scene decided to knock on the door of Adam Strong's basement apartment. They recall him putting his head down and making a comment almost instantaneously that the jig's up. It's a body.
Imagine being a plumber and getting called out to unclog a drain seemed routine enough, right? Until you realize, I have to call the police because I'm pretty sure I just stumbled upon a crime. Let me show you.
Communications.
I'm a plumber and I'm on site for a job. And we've got, we're snaking a drain. And we've been pulling back, we probably pulled back about 10 pounds, 15 pounds of, like, it looks like flesh type of stuff. Meat, and we don't know what it is.
The issue started several days before. He didn't want any plumbers called. He tried snaking the drain himself. He was taking efforts to fix it. By the 29th, it was getting so bad. The smell, the pipes were backing up into the people's bathtubs. People upstairs just took it upon themselves to call a plumber. The officers on the scene decided to knock on the door of Adam Strong's basement apartment. They recall him putting his head down and making a comment almost instantaneously that the jig's up. It's a body.
Some people are just not well on the head, and it baffles me sometimes to think what possesses these people to actually do such things.
Mysterious 12,000-year-old skull with electronic microchip implanted. In a 347 kilometers long cave deep underwater, researchers have discovered a mysterious skull implanted with electronic microchips like in a sci-fi movie. This location is located in Mexico. The team led by Guillermo, he said, this huge cave consists of 250 pits, formed naturally, and contains 198 ruins, of which 140 ruins belong to the Mayans. The researchers found a human skull lying in limestone, inside with a metal plate. Mexican journalist Pedro Sanchez said, he received confidential information from a supplier. This skull is actually implanted with an artificial device. At first, the researchers thought it was just a regular metal plate embedded in the brain, but after further research, it's something completely different. The researchers decided to avoid talking about it, because the technology of the time was not in line with our understanding. According to Sanchez, this is a microchip that was implanted 12,000 years ago. Because the case is top secret, until now no one knows why the electronic chip was implanted in the head of the Mayans in such ancient time.
What if we are living in a life cycle and the Mayan times they're referring to there is the times that we are living in now, and we are just the reincarnation of the exact people who were living back then, and history is just repeating itself?
There might be a biological difference in people who see the paranormal. Listen to immunologist Gary Nolan. He spent a lot of time looking at the MRIs of brains of UFO experiences and concluded that these people all had more pronounced bundles of nerves at the head of their caudate and putamen.
Yeah, that they're basically smarter and they realize what's sitting in front of them and they don't ignore it.
Nolan is saying that there could be something hardwired into these people's brains that allow them to see things that most people don't. What's even crazier is he's saying that the people who have this trait might be attracted to each other and are passing it on through their children. Are we seeing the start of a new species of man? One that can more easily see things which others ignore or brush aside? Or has this speciation already been going on for thousands of years and we're only just now at the tipping point?
I don't think it's anything to do with being smarter, but maybe to do with being more spiritually awake. But I do believe in, like, the paranormal, but I don't believe in ghosts and that sort of thing. I believe that it's all demonic in nature.
Yeah.
would love to be on that bus because that would be one hell of an adrenaline rush.
And my age is 141 years old now.
You are 141 years old?
Right now.
So is your medicine make you live so long?
Yeah. I mean, I have no sugar. I mean, I have no pressure. I mean, I have no heart attack. I mean, I have no PM. Yeah, you know, my farm, I do everything said here. Well, I work with the moon, and the moon is that give you like when the moon is kind of full and the new moon, you try to prepare your herbs, and before the moon full, then you will boil your herbs. So I work with humanity. I'm a healer through the power of the Most High. So through the herbs and water. So no matter what's the problem you have, there is something in the herbs for you. Because the Most High said, the leaves of the tree are healing up the nation. You understand what I mean? So then we must attain ourselves to the herbs. Yeah? And the herb will heal us. Cramp, pain, and all of them something, the bad tumor. Because look, in year 2002, the doctor diagnosed me with cancer. Say, I have cancer. And say, if me, he said, go cut me. And if me not cut me, now live longer than 6 months. I may prove him wrong. With my medicine, me not have no cancer because guess what? We all born with cancer cell. So when you say you have cancer, you're supposed to find the cause before the cure. What's the cause? Yes, just bought something and burn up your cells.
I say fair play to this woman because she's only eating what God provided us with. But is she really 141 years old? I mean, that's kind of debatable. I mean, I'm 23 years old and I think, you know, now come on, that's not on. I don't look old for my age. No, I'm messing. No, I'm 33. But to be honest with you, like 70 or 80 years of age at most, I would want to be here. I think, you know, 141 years of age is just overstaying at that point.
She permanently blinded herself because she identifies as trans-able. Jules Schuping has had the dream of being blind since she was 6 years old. At the age of 21, she decided to actually make her dreams a reality. At first, she would spend hours staring directly at the sun, hoping to damage her eyesight, but she hated the fact that she could still see, so she did the unthinkable. She found a doctor that agreed to help her blind herself by putting drain cleaner into her eye. They even waited over 30 minutes before going to a real hospital to make sure that there was permanent eye damage, which has now left her 100% blind. After her family found out that she did this on purpose, they never talked to her again. But Jules somehow says she's the happiest she's ever been. And she's not the only person who wants to become disabled. Here's a woman who chose to live a similar life in a different way. But Jules has since become an advocate for trans-able people. She emphasizes that her actions were driven by a deep psychological need and not the desire for attention.
I never did like see my reflection.
Why would you think it's a good idea to make yourself blind? I mean, did you just wake up one day and say, right, that's it, I'm just going to go ahead and make myself blind for the rest of my life and that's it? I mean, what goes on in people's heads, I don't know.
Discoveries capture the imagination as profoundly as the concept of entities that exist outside of our realm. Dr. Daniel Nems, a pioneering scientist and researcher, stands at the forefront of this intriguing field. Nems is renowned for his creation of an innovative energy device known as Energy Vision, which, according to his claims, can photograph these mysterious entities. Dr. Daniel Nems is a scientist with a background in quantum physics and energy research. Nems devoted his career to exploring the intersections of energy, matter, and dimensions beyond our conventional understanding. He soon became fascinated by theories of parallel dimensions and alternate realities. Oddly enough, despite publishing these findings, there is a scarcity of information available on him, and the majority of his work has been wiped from the internet. As a result, some have suggested that shortly after sharing these discoveries, he vanished. Nems' interest in this research was partly inspired by the pioneering work of theoretical physicists who posited the existence of multiple dimensions beyond the familiar three-dimensional space. Driven by curiosity and a desire to push the boundaries of human knowledge, Nems began experimenting with novel energy devices aimed at detecting and interacting with these unseen realms. Energy Vision, the groundbreaking device developed by Daniel Nems, represents the culmination of years of research and experimentation. The device combines principles from quantum mechanics, electromagnetism, and advanced imaging technology to purportedly capture images of entities existing in dimensions parallel to our own. Energy Vision consists of a sophisticated array of sensors and emitters that generate and detect specific frequencies of electromagnetic energy. These frequencies are theorized to resonate with the energy signatures of these beings, making them visible to the device's sensors. The captured data is then processed by advanced algorithms to produce visual images, which are displayed on a high-resolution screen. The device operates by emitting a controlled burst of energy into a defined area and then scanning the area for any anomalies in the energy field. According to NEMS, these mysterious beings interact with these energy fields in ways that are detectable by Energy Vision's sensors. The resulting images reveal shapes and forms that do not correspond to any known physical entities, suggesting the presence of beings from other dimensions. If the device's capabilities are validated, the implications for science and our understanding of the universe would be profound. The ability to photograph these entities would provide tangible evidence for the existence of parallel dimensions, supporting theories that have long been speculative. This breakthrough could revolutionize fields such as physics, cosmology, and even...
I believe there are two worlds, the world that we can see and the world that we can't. And I do believe that the world that we can't see, there's a lot of demonic presence that's controlling a lot of what's happening in the world today. And a lot of people might believe in aliens, but I've never believed in aliens. I've always believed that demons are aliens. And I do think it'll play a huge part in the end times as well.
Ah, Christ, here we go. Bloody teal Vader. Just stop oil. I get in with the door. Just stop oil. Oil is king, mate.
If you like these topics, I've got more topics right here, but thanks for chilling out with me to the very end, and if you haven't already, go ahead and smash that like button and subscribe button, because it'll really help out and support the channel. But until the next video, guys, look after yourselves, stay safe and stay healthy, and I'll see you then.